بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم اجعل تجمعنا هذا تجمعا مرحوما وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما، ولا تجعل فينا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما، إنك ولي ذلك والقادر عليه. أما بعد، يقول المولى جل وعلا: وإذ قال موسى لقومه إن الله يأمركم أن تذبحوا بقرة، قالوا أتتخذنا هزوا، قال أعوذ بالله أن أكون من الجاهلين. موسى عليه السلام is delivering a message on behalf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, commanding his people to slaughter a cow. The immediate answer came from his people: أتتخذنا هزوا، are you taking us as a mockery, are you making fun of us? Why would Musa alayhi salam request his people to slaughter a cow? And why are they saying أَتَتَّخِذُنَا هُزُوَا? In the latter part of the ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the reasoning. The story goes is that a young man who was looking forward to inherit his uncle. And his uncle was a righteous person. So the uncle did not have any children. So the sole inheritor of the wealth is his nephew. His nephew wanted to hasten the inheritance process, so he did a plan. And the plan is, he would kill his uncle, he would carry his body at night, he would put it in front of one of the homes of the Israelites, and this way, not only he will get the inheritance, but he will also get the diyah for killing somebody. When someone kills another person, there's a ransom or a diyah. It's like a penalty, a monetary penalty that is paid to the family of the deceased. So he thought this plan out, he plotted the plan, he killed his uncle, he took him to this home and he laid him in front of the house. In the morning, they start accusing one another. Who killed this person? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذْ قَتَلْتُمْ نَفْسًا فَادَّارَأْتُمْ فِيهَا. And when you've killed the soul, فَادَّارَأْتُمْ means that everyone is pushing the accusation away from themselves and pointing the finger at others. فَادَّارَأْتُمْ فِيهَا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided them to go and ask Musa alayhi salam. When they went to ask Moses, peace be unto him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to deliver a message to his people to slaughter a cow. وَإِذْ قَتَلْتُمْ نَفْسًا فَادَّارَأْتُمْ فِيهَا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands them to slaughter a cow. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تَذْبَحُوا بَقَرًا. So here Musa alayhi salam is delivering this message to them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in response to your inquiry as to who killed this person, is commanding you to slaughter a cow. They did not see the connection. They said, أَتَتَّخِذُنَا هُزُوَا, are you making fun of us? We ask him who killed this person and you command us to slaughter a cow. قَالَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ أَنْ أَكُونَ مِنَ الْجَاهِلِينَ. He said, I seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I be among the ignorant one. I am a prophet. I am a messenger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the question comes, قَالُوا ادْعُوا لَنَا رَبَّكَ يُبَيِّن لَنَا مَا هِي. Of course, this is the wrong question to ask. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding them to slaughter a cow. So now, you ask in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they're saying, ادْعُوا لَنَا رَبَّك. Instead of saying, ادْعُوا لَنَا رَبَّنَا, call unto our Lord. Said, Rabbak, you know, distancing themselves from Iman. And, you know, the takleef means that the ordination of them doing what they're supposed to be, doing what they're commanded to do. قَالُوا ادْعُوا لَنَا رَبَّكَ يُبَيِّن لَنَا مَا هِي. This is the wrong question, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already stated it's a cow. So you ask him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as to what is it? It's a cow. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered them by giving them some information about this cow. So there's no confusion. قَالَ إِنَّهُ يَقُولُ إِنَّهَا بَقَرَةٌ لَا فَارِضٌ وَلَا بِكْرٌ عَوَانٌ بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is a cow that's neither very old nor very young. عَوَان means right in the middle. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to put an end to this argument. فَافْعَلُوا مَا تُؤْمَرُونَ. Now do as you commanded. So you should not really follow this up with another question. عَوَانٌ بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ, somewhere in the middle, you would go, you'd buy a cow, you slaughtered. Another question came in, as if they've learned something from the first answer. They said, قَالُوا ادْعُوا لَنَا رَبَّكَ يُبَيِّن لَنَا مَا لَوْنُهَا. Now, call unto your Lord again, not our Lord, your Lord. So he would explain to us and give us more characteristics of this cow. So here, the more they've asked, the more the pool of cows to be slaughtered is shrinking now. قال إنه يقول إنها بقرة صفراء. So it's yellow. فاقع لونها. Not any yellow. فاقع لونها. Very bright yellow. Not only very bright yellow. تسر الناظرين. So these three conditions must exist now. What is the answer? They're still asking for more details. قال ادع لنا ربك يبين لنا ما هي إن البقرة تشابه علينا. Now, all of these questions show that they're not really interested in executing the order. So they're asking for more and more information. قال ادع لنا ربك يبين لنا ما هي قال إنه يقول إنها بقرة لا ذلول تثير الأرض ولا تسقي الحرث مسلمة لا شية فيها. Now, all of these conditions must exist in addition to, it is not a cow that's been trained to, you know, work in the land. Or to deliver water to the land, to the crops. لا شيئة فيها, there is absolutely no faults in it whatsoever. Now the search begins. There's a story to this cow, and this goes to show how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala مسبب الأسباب, you will place certain things for certain wisdoms. This cow, there was only one of a kind of this cow. And the story of this cow is that this man who was known to be a very righteous man, when he was about to die, he left a wife and a young boy behind. So he summoned his wife and he said, all I am leaving for my boy is just this one small cow. وَأَسْتَوْدِعُ هَذَا الْعِجْلِ اللَّهِ I put this عجل, this cow, in the possession of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a trust. So let it, you know, graze the land and nobody bothers it. So they unleashed it. They unleashed it. When the boy got older, and this boy was also a righteous young man when he grew older, following the footsteps of his father, and he used to be a hattab, meaning that he would collect wood, one third of which he would give to his mother, one third of which he would keep for his family, and one third of which he would give fi sabilillah. That was his daily chores. At night, one third of the night, he would do qiyam al-layl. One third of the night, he would sleep. So one third of the night he would do qiyam al-layl. One third of the night he would sleep. And one third of the night he would tend to his mother's needs. So all of his days and nights are divided into three parts. So the young man now is older. So his mother tells him that your father has left, you know, a cow for you. We don't know where it is. He said, well, am I going to search after it? It's just like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responding to your father's dua, when he said, أَسْتَوْدِعُكَ هَذَا الْعِجْلِ I put this ajl in your trust. Call unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to return this trust to you. So he did, and this cow came running to him. So now, he has a possession of this cow in addition to whatever he earns from his daily chores. Now, the Israelites in search of this cow, they couldn't find it. So some of them spotted this cow in the possession of this young man. So they came to his house, and they try to put a value on it. What is the value? 3 dirhams. He said, I've given a covenant to my mother not to sell this cow without consultation. So he would go to his mother and he would consult her. She said, no, that is too low. He would go back to them, says, this is too low. They said, we'll double the money. And then we'll triple and quadruple. And then at one point they said, we'll give you this much money without consulting your mother. He said, by Allah, if you give me the weight of this cow in gold, I will not accept it without the consultation and the approval of my mother. So he went, and at the end, they ended up paying the weight of the cow in gold. So there are two faults here. There's a punishment for the Israelites for the continuing questioning and tightening the criteria that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made very open for them. And then there is the amana that this older man, before he died, placed in the trust of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala returned this amana to him, the weight of gold. So now, they take possession of this cow. And now they slaughter the cow. فَقُلْنَا ضْرِبُوهُ بِبَعْضِهَا So we said,
take part of this gal. And notice here the lesson is that there's a dead man here, and there's a dead cow here. So you take part of the dead, and you hit the dead with it. What happens? The dead comes to life. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not only says, okay, O Moses, I'm going to, you know, bring this person to life, but rather he's showing them his miracles and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrect the dead. So he says, فَقُلْنَا اضْرِبُوهُ بِبَعْضِهَا كَذَلِكَ يُحْيِي اللَّهُ الْمَوْتَى. So now you see it before your own eyes, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings the dead back to life. So this person came back to life. He said, the one who killed me is the son of my brother, my nephew. As a result, that resolved the issue, of course. And as a result, this person was deprived from inheritance. In the Sharia, there's a rule that the scholars set for us. مَنْ اسْتَعْجَلَ شَيْئًا قَبْلَ أَوَانِهِ عُقِبَ بِحِرْمَانِهِ. Whoever hastens a thing before the due time, the punishment is that they shall be deprived of it. Whoever hastens a thing before its due time, he or she will be punished by being deprived from, you know, whatever it is that they're entitled to. فَقُلْنَا اضْرِبُوهُ بِبَعْضِهَا كَذَلِكَ يُحْيِي اللَّهُ الْمَوْتَى وَيُرِيكُمْ آيَاتِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. So thus, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring the dead back to life. Just like when Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he said, قَالَ رَبِّ أَرِنِي كَيْفَ تُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could have said, I'm going to bring back to life anything that you bring. Or slaughter these birds and I'll bring them back to life. But the absolute power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dictated that it is Ibrahim alayhi salam that slaughters these birds, that is the Israelites that slaughter this cow, not anybody else, that it's them that were going to take the action, be it Ibrahim alayhi salam summoning the birds, or be it the Israelites taking part of this cow and striking the dead with it. And this is the absolute power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He's able to transfer His ability to bring back the dead to somebody else. In other words, you're going to do it. By my will, you're going to do it. As Isa alayhi salam said, وَأُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has transferred part of His power to me, that I'm able to bring back the dead. So from this, as you can see, we learn from the qasas of the Quran so many words of wisdom, so many lessons that we're able to have this deep conviction and continue to grow it in the abilities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that the meaning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a haqq, is true, undoubtedly. Just like we read in the qasas, just like we see it day in and day out. هذا والله تعالى أعلى وأعلم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خيرا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.